Now then, it's Christmas Eve, and I feel in the mood to fuck things up for everyone, but the question now is, where do I begin? The rest of my family have all fucked off and are doing their own thing, but I can't go anywhere, because once again, I'm fucking grounded. I am miserable as fuck, so I think a plan needs to be taking place. I won't stop until I fuck things up for people.
Luke Harold Stenner. What's your language, young man? That's is the reason why we've grounded you for 10 weeks.
Not a fucking chance, and I reject the grounding, because it's too ridiculous a length.
Luke, I need to have a word with you about your potty mouth. It's not you.
Well, take two, fuck you.
Luke Harold Stenner. How dare you swear at me like that? Your mouth is an absolute disgrace. This isn't the right way to behave on this side of Christmas.
Well, if you think I'm going to listen to some hypocrite about my language, well, you can go and fuck a lamppost.
You just wait. Once we run the new year in, I will make sure you have a punishment that's fitting in cleaning out that potty mouth of yours.
Well, you'll have to catch me first. I'm getting out of here, because I need to get some fresh air. And there's no way in the word of fuck that I'm going to let you stop me.
How the fuck did Luke know about my swearing? I know I swear, but I'll never do it around my kids. I respect them way too much. I wish Luke would see sense, because his foul behavior is really upsetting me.
Now then, we're outside, so what are we going to do now, my sweetness?
We're going to fuck up Christmas for everyone, and we're going to fuck it up, big style.
That's is a mighty fine idea, but which family shall we start off with, and what exactly are we going to do to execute this plan of ours?
First off, we're going to call up a meeting with Boris Johnson and the Alanastiums, because I believe that they all have something up their sleeves.
And that's is where you're tragically mistaken. There is absolutely no way you're going to revive the wretched Alanastiums. It is never going to happen, not on my watch at least.
I don't think you have anything on us or our great big plans, Mr. Brainiac.
Adam, the one and only. Your father has rung me and has asked me to bring you both back home because you're supposed to be grounded. Especially you, Luke, for running that supersized potty mouth of yours.
Says the person who runs his mouth all the time and struts about like he owns the place.
No, he most certainly doesn't, Luke Harold Stenner. You really ought to watch your mouth and attitude. Otherwise I'll see to it that you get grounded for a longer amount of time, and that you get nothing but sprouts and broccoli for every meal, including dessert. Do I make myself clear?
You, Darren, need to fuck off, and you need to fuck off pretty quickly too. I haven't got enough time or patience to be dealing with your bullshit.
I beg your pardon, Luke Harold Stenner. You do not speak to the main leader of the DMC neighborhood like that, ever. Do I make myself clear?
Oh 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 oh. This plan is going to be epic. Thanks so much for including us in this scheme to steal Christmas. It's our opportunity to get our own backs on our parents, who by the way, are as boring as fuck.
That's is our absolute pleasure, Lolita. I always knew that we would become the best of friends when we came here.
I don't believe this, Darren. We're going to have to alert Sarah. She has the right to know what is going on.
You were not wrong there, Adam. I'll give her a quick call, just so she knows exactly what's is going on, because you're right. She really needs to know what's is about to unfold.
You are not taking any further steps in these plans of ours. You two are going to shut the fuck up, and we'll make sure that you do shut those traps of yours. Viand logic, activate.
Now that's, Luke, was absolutely fucking amazing. You managed to turn Darren and Adam into ice sculptures. I absolutely love that. Now then, let's get down to the idea of how you're going to steal Christmas.
There is a certain problem that's swirling about, but I'm sure we'll manage to solve it. Anyways, we've got some ideas up our sleeves, but do you two have anything that'll help us?
Oh, do we just. We've got a pair of Santa sacks, but we reversed the function. So that it takes all the presents instead of giving them out. We also have a pop-outer. This will cause all the fairy lights to blow with one click of a button. There are other steps we can take as well. If we're not allowed to celebrate, then everyone else can suffer for it.
And with Darren and Adam frozen out of the picture, we can all get into putting paper into action, and no one is going to fuck about with the plans.
Now then, let's get cracking with the ideas of stealing Christmas. First off, we need to find a way to disguise ourselves. Unless we go as we are, no one's going to find out what's going to unfold, but it's going to hit them big style.
Absolutely. Hey, we've got an even better idea. After we've done all that, how's about we go out and celebrate the prospects of what you two have done? You truly deserve all the credit, and we're only too happy to help you with this.
Oh, yes. That sounds fucking amazing, sweet sis. And boy, do we know just the place for us to go out and eat.
Oh my word. I always look forward to doing my job. It amazes me when this time of year comes around. I just simply can't wait for a whole 12 months, so my elves, of whom I give the highest praises to, do a lot of hard work over those 12 months of waiting, and I am one very grateful person.
Now you just hold your horses. Don't you dare take another step towards that tree. Those presents you have are belong to me. Me, I tells you.
Ugh. What are you two doing in this house? Can't you see I'm trying to do my job in making Christmas dreams come true for everyone?
Well, we come bearing some breaking news. Christmas in the DMC neighborhood has been cancelled. We're going to make this a public announcement over all the TV stations in the UK.
Too fucking right we are, my sweetness. Now then, you best fuck off back to the North Pole, as you're the owner of a product called Grounded.
Well. Something tells me your dad used to be a sailor, because that is some very foul language from one of his kids. I can't believe what I'm hearing right now.
Well, try this one for size, fuck shit piss bastard bitch bollocks and another load of fuck. I have the world's biggest potty mouth, and am I scared to use it? No fucking way.
Oh my goodness. What have I gotten myself into? Elves, beam me up, please. I have two very naughty children, and one who swears like a trooper. I can't be dealing with this atrocious behavior.
Oh wow. Did you just see that? Santa just disappeared out of sight. Now then, let's us get to returning this room back to normal, and then we can get moving on to the next house. And, with Darren and Adam frozen solid, and temperatures set to go down to minus 10, they'll be staying as ice for all eternity.
Absolutely. We're going to have a great time cancelling Christmas for everyone, and no one will be able to stop us.
This plan is going to rock all chronic, and I feel absolutely amazing about this notion.
Well, what have we got to lose? We're not going to get anywhere, if we're faff-assing about like two constipated shits.
I agree with you, my sweetness. So, without further deliberations, let's get going and messing things up for everyone.
Say, Emily, my honey, do you know where Adam's gone? He's supposed to have gone out to get some food for the party, and it's been nearly an hour.
I'm not too sure, Mum. All I know is that I can see two ice sculptures outside down the road from the house, and they're both different colors of ice. Do you know what they could be of?
You may want to take another look, Emily. I've just had a phone call from Sarah asking where Darren was. He was supposed to have gone out to get some bin bags, but he's been gone for nearly an hour too.
Wait. What are you trying to say, Colin? Could our son be one of those ice sculptures?
I think he's onto something, Mum, which can only mean one thing. If one of those ice sculptures is Adam.
That the other one is Darren? Emily, Juliet, we need to alert Sarah of our potential breakthrough of what's happened. If we don't get out there in enough time, poor Darren and Adam will become like snowmen.
There's something else that needs to be noted too, my man and dad.
I think I may have noted it too, my baby.
Ever since the Stenner family have come to live inside the DMC neighborhood, their son had been swearing non-stop. He's even worse than Adam when it comes to the potty mouth.
I agree with you, honey. At least Adam knows where to draw the line, but the Stenner's son has no respect. I was with Adam on the train last week, and I saw the son kick off, because he didn't get a particular donut he requested.
Say, Mum, I can see someone throwing a tantrum outside, but it's looking like some adult. Shall we go and have a look at what's going on?
Shall we look outside the window and see what's going on?
That is sounding like an idea, Colin. You know, just in case something else magical happens inside the DMC neighborhood.
I have to say this, my love, but this evening has been fucking amazing. Thanks for coming to my rescue when I needed it. We have an announcement to make, which is getting broadcast in about 20 minutes, but with good old Viand logic, we'll be able just to teleport there.
And we can all be rest assured that no one will fuck about with our plans either. We will come out on top as the world's greatest siblings.
Absolutely, sweet sis, but I can't help but note that a tantrum is about to take place around here, and the noise is doing my brain in.
Catherine, why did you have to bring me out here? It's bloody freezing out here, and the temperature is set to go down to minus 10. I want back inside.
Oh my goodness. Dave, will you stop throwing your tantrums for once in your life? I swear you're giving me a first-class headache.
Not unless you agree to take me back to me without saying freezing minutes off.
Dave, did you see that? Your tantrum is cracking the ice, and wow, I didn't think that would happen. In that case, continue throwing your tantrum, because I reckon you'll have these two kind and gentle souls freed in no time.
Oh wow. Catherine, my luscious toffee pizza. I never knew I could do that. In that case, I shall continue throwing my tantrum, because this is Darren and Adam. They need freeing from that icy prison of theirs.
And I shall sit here and watch you give your absolute worst. What's the one thing that you really like at McDonald's, but can't have because they keep running out?
Oh yeah, that's right. It's the one thing Darren likes too. I remember seeing them both and Darren had a similar meltdown to the one I'm about to have. Watch out guys, special Dave tantrum starting in 3, 2, 1. I want a festic pie, and I want a festic pie right now, you hear me?
Keep going, my wondrous festive pudding. You're doing amazing. I reckon if you do the motor car crying at the end of that, you will have these two for Eid.
It's Aunt Kelp Calvin got killed like a mean syndrome with its triggers of fact the smallest things. You want to stay, and you want to treat no.
Wait. Dave the childish dad. Your tantrum freed me and Darren from our icy prisons. Thank you very much. How can I ever repay you?
Don't worry about it, Adam. I never realized that my tantrums could do that until Catherine pointed it out.
Congratulations, Dave. Now this is one moment to be proud of, and I'm really proud of you, my juicy tender sausage. How's about we go off to McDonald's to celebrate your victory?
I would love to, my juicy cherry muffin, but after we save Christmas in the DMC neighborhood. I have two self-entitled brats to be giving a piece of my mind. Darren, Adam, if you want to go off somewhere nice and warm, Catherine and I will take over from here. You two must be freezing over there.
Now usually, I would like to give a helping hand when saving this neighborhood of mine, but I reckon I will need a bit of warming up first, as I am freezing to the core.
Same here, Darren. Come on. Let's us go and have a Bailey's hot chocolate. That should surely do the trick.
That's is absolutely brilliant, Adam. Thank you very much.
No worries, Darren. So when you're ready, let's go, now.
Now then, we're here, and this is our moment to cancel Christmas for everyone, and potentially fuck everything up. And yes, if you have a problem with my potty mouth, then I suggest you go to someone who gives a fuck, because I sure as hell don't.
And this is where you are tragically mistaken, Luke and Amanda Stanner. I've managed to free Darren and Adam from their icy prisons, and they're now warming up. Now then, you just wait, because some serious stuff is going down.
Wait. Isn't that Dave the childish dad? The one who threw a hissy fit over not wanting to go to church, and wanting to watch Barney the Dinosaur?
And what's that got to do with the price of festive pies? I may be childish, but I've come to save Christmas from getting ruined by the like of two self-centered little brats such as you two.
Well, well, well. You are a little too late, Mr. Immature in Disguise. What the fuck has?
And another thing is, Luke Harold Stenner. You are going to watch that language of yours, and you're going to do that, right now. I have a childlike imagination, and it's very much pure and innocent. I will not have that bubble burst by someone swearing like a monstrous troop at an army campsite.
Come on. Let's us get out of here. We're not going to penetrate the mind of this childish dad, and it's is really doing my nut in.
Yes. That's is exactly what I thought. Now then, before you have the time to escape, I am going to cast Vient Logic, and I'm sending you back to your parents. Vient Logic. Activate. There. That's is a whole lot better. Now then, I'm going to save Christmas, and then I'm going to go back to my wonderful wife and kids, of whom I loved bits.
Luke Harold and Amanda Leanne Stenner. What's is the meaning of your unacceptable behavior?
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, Dad. I was a sweet ickle angel all day.
Oh. Luke Harold Stenner. Watch your language, young man. We didn't bring you up to have a potty mouth.
Now then, for your punishments. For trying to cancel Christmas, you are now the owners of a product called Grounded. Amanda, yours is valid for 10 days, and Luke, yours is valid for 3 weeks. Go to your rooms, right now. We will call you down when dinner is ready.
I can't believe you're doing this to us, innocent little angels. But I promise you one thing. We will get our revenge on you, Darren James Stratton. You won't see it coming, but believe me, it is coming, and it's going to bite you in the fucking arse.
That does it. In the new year, we are going to take Luke to see a specialist, because he shouldn't have a potty mouth at his age.